Good evening. Welcome to today's UPSC Current Affairs of 21st April 2021. So let's move to the first topic of the day. So the first topic is RCEP. So what is RCEP? So RCEP generally means Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. So in from this word we can we are able to understand that it is fully based upon the regional cooperation for the achievement or for the effectiveness of the economic related activities of the Asian countries. Okay, so why was in this news? So actually Singapore Foreign Minister Vivian Balakrishnan said he hoped that India would reassess its stand on regional trading agreement such as Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership and the Comprehensive and Progressive Agreement for Trans-Pacific Partnership. So at present we are going to look on to the two topics, so RCEP and CPTPP. So first of all, let us try to understand what is RCEP. So RCEP, which has been signed between the 15 Asian Pacific nation. So RC is being signed between 15 Asian Pacific nation. So the RCEP nation, those are, it include Asian members, ASEAN. So what is this ASEAN member? So ASEAN members, okay. So ASEAN members plus five trade partners. So those are Australia, China, Japan, South Korea and New Zealand. So first of all, let us try to understand who are the members of the ASEAN countries. Okay, so ASEAN members. So the ASEAN members are Brunei, Cambodia, Indonesia, Laos, Malaysia, Myanmar, Philippines, Singapore, Thailand and Vietnam. And including the ASEAN countries, it will also include the five trade partners. So those are Australia, China, Japan, South Korea and New Zealand. Okay, so what is the main purpose of RCEP? So the main purpose of RCEP is to make or for the easier for the product and services of each of those country, and it must also to be enabled across the region. Okay, so what are the agreement which includes? So it also includes on the rules on the intellectual property, telecommunication, financial and professional services, and also it also includes e-commerce. It also includes e-commerce. So generally the RCEP nation, which include 15 countries, it almost covered 2.2 billion people, and also it accounts for the 30% of the world economy. So it also consists of 30% of the world economy. So RCEP is being described as the largest regional trading agreement at present days, and RCEP was originally being negotiated between 16 countries, but at present India has not put a signatory on the RCEP deal. So India is now being withholding the deal. Okay, so let's look on the next criteria. Why did not India join the RCEP agreement? So India has planned to exit from the RCEP. So what is the reason for the India's exit on RCEP? Let's look on the topic. So okay, so in November 2019, the India announced its decision to not join the RCEP. So what could be the major reason for India exist on RCEP? So the main reason for India existing the RCEP deal is due to the local producers are getting affected in the particular deal. And also if we sign RCEP deal with the other 15 countries, so China's product will be flooding into our economy, so it will affect our local producers in our country, and also it will make some problem in our Making India initiative and Atmanirbhar Bharat. Okay, so let's look onto the concerns. So what are the major concerns? So this amid concerns that elimination of tariff would open India's market to import, which in turn could harm the local producers. So if we eliminate the tariff which we export or import from other country, from our country to the other country, so the elimination of tariff between the export and import system, it will obviously affect our Indian economy and as well as of the producers of those who are making the products. Okay, so India has suggested some remedy measures. For instance, if the import rise beyond a threshold product, so they should be allowed to impose some kind of barrier. So for example, if you are exporting some basmati rice to other country, for example, let us take Myanmar. So if you are exporting basmati rice to Myanmar, so there will not be any tariff, there will not be any tax. So the huge product will be shifting from our country to their country. Okay, so obviously in our economy the goods will be very limited. In that economy the goods will be more effective and more efficient. Okay, so if the particular product, if it is not been put under the tariff system, so obviously both the economy are going to suffer. So India has planned and India has given some suggestion that if RCEP deal, we have to sign the RCEP deal, we must, so India must, and India have some suggestion that must include tariff must be included. But the other 15 countries have rejected that India should not put barriers on the product. Okay, so that is the main reason why India is not signing the deal. What are the other concerns? So the next concern will be the imbalance in the negotiation between goods and services, and it will allow India's proposal to allow free movement of Indian skilled professional in the RCEP region. Indian industry were also worried that RCEP allowing a wide range of goods to import at zero tariff. So if we import at zero tariff, China, in the world's biggest producer, on the, which produce at a cheap cost, the Chinese goods will flood the Indian market, so which will cause damage to our Make in India movement or Make in India initiative and the Atmanirbhar Bharat. Okay, so as well as we know that India has having a very trade deficit. Out of 15 countries, we have trade deficit with 11 countries, and some experts feel that India has been unable to leverage its existing bilateral free trade agreement with several RCEP members to increase the export. Okay, so let's move on to the next. What is CPTPP? So Comprehensive and Progressive Agreement for the Trans-Pacific Partnership. So what is CPTPP? So it is a free trade agreement between 11 countries around the Pacific Rim. So those Pacific Rim countries are Canada, Mexico, Peru, Chile, New Zealand, Australia, Brunei, Singapore, Malaysia, Vietnam and Japan. Okay, so USA had withdrawn from this FTA. Sorry, USA had withdrawn from the FTA of the Trans-Pacific Partnership or TPP. So the remaining 11 participants have scrambled to amend the text of the agreement. So they newly renamed the TPP as a CPTPP in March 2018. So they changed the name from TPP to CPTPP. Okay, so they have changed the name in 2018. And also the Comprehensive and Progressive Agreement for Trans-Pacific Partnership removed 99% of tariff on goods and services, just like original TPP did. Okay, so the CPTPP covers a broad range of goods and services. These include financial services, telecommunication and food safety standard. All countries have also agreed to cut down the wildlife trafficking that helps the trafficking animals such as elephant, rhinoceros, marine species the most. Okay, and also prevents environmental abuse such as unsustainable logging and fishing. Countries that do not comply will face trade penalties. So they are having a huge penalty module system. If we did not follow that system, we will be getting huge fine. So India is not a member. India is not. India did not sign the CPTPP as it seeks to place a greater labor and environmental standards on the other partners. And CPTPP draft include narrowly detailed qualification on standard for the investment protection and provision to protect the host state's right to regulate and imposition of the detailed transparency requirement. Okay, so let's move on to the next topic. The rhinos translocated under IRV 2020. So what is this IRV? What is this IRV? So IRV refers India Rhino Vision 2020. So why was in this news? So actually the IRV 2020 come to end with the release of two rhinos, an adult male and adult female, in Assam's Manas National Park. It was being translocated or transported from Pobitoda. What is the main aim of the Indian Rhino Vision 2020? So it aims to attain a population of 3,000 wild rhinos in Assam, distributed over 7 of its protected area by the year 2022. So when was it started? So it was started at the year 2005. So it was designed by Rhino Task Force, and it is being implemented through the Department of Environment and Forest of Government of Assam, along with the Worldwide Fund for Nature. Fund for Nature, WWF. Okay, so what is the main aim of this India Rhino Mission? So improving the protection of rhino in all rhino region. We know that the Brahmaputra region or the Assam is a place, or we can also say that Kaziranga, Manas, Orang National Park are the most densely populated rhinoceros we are having. Okay, so the translocating rhinos from two source population, Kaziranga and Pobitoda, into 3 to 4 target protected area, Manas, Lokwa, Bura Chapori, Kochmora, Dibrus Haikohova, and possibly Orang. So just they are saying that they will be translocated in the all those regions. It is a place where we are having a huge rhino population. So where is Manas National Park located? So actually the Manas National Park is located in Assam. So what are the river flows in that particular region or the particular national park? So it is Manas River, Sankosh Rivers, and Dhansuri River. So Manas is the only landscape in the world where pristine dry grassland are seen merging with the Babar grassland, interspread with a diverse habitat ascending to semi-evergreen forest and then into the Bhutan Himalaya. So Manas National Park is obviously an universal world heritage site, and it is also a tiger reserve. Okay, so let's look about the map. So Assam is being bordered by China, Bhutan, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Myanmar, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, Bangladesh, and Meghalaya. Okay, so these are some of these foreign territories and Indian territory which are being sharing land boundary with the Assam region. So what is the capital of Assam? So it is Dispur, D-I-S-P-U-R. Okay, let's move on to the next topic. S-400 Triumph. So what is S-400? So actually this is a security based question in the mains paper. So actually we are for, and if we take on to the prelims perspective, so UPSC is gonna ask very simple question. So S-400 is taken, or we are buying S-400 from which of the following countries? So we must write the answer blindly that it is taken, or if we are buying it from Russia. We are buying it from Russia. Okay, so why was in this news? Actually, the Russia government or Russian defense organization has agreed to supply S-400 missile to Indian defense security system. Okay, so why was in this news? Actually, the official dismissed concern over possible US sanction on the deal under the Countering America's Advisories through Sanction Act, CATSA, so stating the deal met national security consideration. Okay, so what is the content of this article? Okay, the S-400 Triumph, so NATO reporting name, so NATO, North Atlantic Treaty Organization, reports the S-400 as SA-24 Growler. So what is S-400? It is an air defense missile system developed by Russia. So the S-400 Triumph defense system integrates a multifunction radar, autonomous detection, targeting system, anti-aircraft missile system, launchers, and command and the control center. So it is capable of firing 3 type of missile to create a layered defense. Okay, so S-400 can be implemented in Indian Navy, Indian Army, and Indian Air Force. So this, both the armed forces are coming under Ministry of Defense and the Central Armed Police Force, so which include CISF, Central Industrial of Security Force, BSF, Border Security Force, ITBP, Indo-Tibetan Border Police, SSB, Shashastra Seema Bal, CRPF, Central Reserve Police Force, NSG, National Security Guard. So this all CAPF are coming under the Ministry of Home Affairs. So the next, the system can engage all type of aerial target, including aircraft, unmanned aerial vehicle, UAV, and ballistic and cruise missile within the range of 400 km. So it is a range, it is having a range of 400 km and also the altitude of 30 km. So system can simultaneously engage 36 targets. It can also be integrated into the existing and future air defense unit of Air Force, Army and Navy. So what is CATSA? So Countering America's Advisories Through Sanction Act is an act made by US legislature. So CATSA is an act made by only US government or the US lawmakers. So which mandates the US administration to impose sanction on any country carrying out significant defense and energy trade with sanctioned entities in North Korea, Iran and Russia. Okay, so US has given sanction on India because we are buying S-400 from Russia. So that was in this news. Okay, next, prelims based question. So first question, consider the following statement regarding RCEP. So okay, consider the following statement regarding the members of RCEP. So they are asking for the members. Okay, so select the correct quote from the following statement. So let's look on the option, statement. So first one, Indonesia, obviously Indonesia member of RCEP. Thailand, yes, obviously Thailand is a member of RCEP. Japan is a member. Australia is a member. So the answer goes, which of the following statement is correct? They have asked for the correct statement. So the answer goes on D, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Next question, which of the following national park or wildlife sanctuary are present in Assam? They have asked in particularly Assam region, but not in India. Okay, so we have to read the question very properly. Okay, they have asked for Assam region. Amatskang Wildlife Sanctuary, Kaziranga National Park, Dibru Sahyawok National Park, Deeparbel Wildlife Sanctuary. Select the incorrect quote from the following statement. So they have asked for the incorrect statement. So Kaziranga is a part of Assam, Dibru Sahyawok is a part of Assam. So come on, let's look on to the 2 and 3. So obviously we are not getting any option relating to 2 and 3, as this 2 and 3 option of the correct statement. So they have asked for incorrect statement, so the answer goes for D. So there is a logic behind this option. So once again I am trying to explain it. So we know that Kaziranga is a part of Assam, is a place, it is located in Assam. Kaziranga National Park is located in Assam, and also we know that Dibru Sahyawok National Park is located in Assam. So they have asked for, just we don't know Amatskang Wildlife Sanctuary and Deeparbel Wildlife Sanctuary, we don't know where it is located. Okay, so we know that second and third statement, or the second and third statement, we 100% know that it is located in Assam. So from this two and second and third statement, we are going to eliminate and we are going to arrive at the answer. Okay, so if they are asking for the correct statement, it will be very difficult for us to select the correct option. So we are lucky that they have asked for the incorrect statement. So we obviously know that 2 and 3 are located in Assam. Okay, so from the quotes given below, we do not have any option 2 and 3. Okay, so we only have 1 and 3, 2 and 4, 1, 2 and 3, sorry, 1, 3 and 4 and none option. So obviously the answer is none. Okay, because they have asked for the incorrect statement. So the option is D. Okay, so the option is D. Okay, so that's all for today's current affairs. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Thank you and bye.